Welcome, Jake. Great to finally get the chance to chat to you. You've been here a few days now, so tell us about your early impressions of Glasgow so far.
Yeah, things have been great. I'm settling in easy. The guys are very welcoming. It's been an awesome time around the rink. It's only been a few days, but things are on the upturn, and it's a great group of guys, so I've enjoyed it so far.
As you touched upon there, quite a manic few days last week before you got here, settled in. You had the games at the weekend and stuff, so you're starting to find a routine now.
Yeah, it was a little bit of trial by fire at the beginning. I obviously only got in for one practice before the Friday game, and then thrown right into a game. It was great to be at home. The fans there are awesome. It was a packed house, and then only got one more skate in before our game down in Coventry. It was awesome. I miss being back at the rink. It's been great to compete, and the guys are working hard. Obviously, we've had a little bit of speed bumps so far, and it's good to be in a place where we're on the upturn. But as far as settling in, things have been awesome.
I think I'm right in saying that was your first game since the end of last season when you played the playoff weekend, which we'll talk about a little bit later. So it must have been nice to get the rust off at least.
Yeah, for sure. I was glad. It would have been great to have a full week of practice beforehand, but I've been on the ice. I run a company in the summer that does training for kids from the age of 10 all the way through Division I college. So I'm on the ice all summer. I've been around the rinks, but it was the first real game since our playoff weekend when I was with Guildford. It was great to get into the mix. And obviously, with the low numbers, playing a lot of minutes and, that helped. I'm glad that I was able to be a contributing factor, but it was a bit of chaos getting in quick, but I think things have gone pretty well.
So let's go all the way back to the start of your career, Jake. When did you realize a career in ice hockey was for you?
When I realized it was for me, it was probably, shortly after college, my college season ended. I've always wanted this to be the case, ever since I was a kid. Hockey was my first love, my biggest love. This was always the goal to make a living out of it. And I've been super fortunate to do this for, 7 years now. It's always a little bit stressful when you're finishing the college year and looking for a team. And, I was lucky enough to leave Holy Cross and sign with the Atlanta Gladiators to start my career and then return there for my first full season. It's a dream come true, to be able to do it for this long, whatever level you play at, is what every kid wants when they're growing up and throwing on the skates as a young buck out there. But, being able to do it this long has been awesome. I've always wanted to.
So who were your childhood heroes as a kid then? Which players did you look up to as you embarked on those early stages?
So my family grew up pretty much exclusively just south of Boston. So I'm a Boston sports fan across the board, Bruins, Patriots, Red Sox, Celtics. I was pretty much exclusively following the Bruins, getting to watch, Patrice Bergeron, Neely, all of our big names, and the fact the Bruins have had a ton of success and being able to see those games and see them do well. They got a Stanley Cup that I got to see the year I graduated from high school, which was awesome. Chara was obviously a big name there. I'm not quite his size, but steady defenseman. Anyone that's seen me play knows that I'm not usually lighting up the highlight reel, but I like to play a safe game, and I've always loved guys like McQuaid and Chara that get things done and help the team progress the puck and play steady and can be reliable.
Of course, you mentioned the Stanley Cup team that the Bruins had about 10 years ago. You may or may not recall that they came over here for an exhibition game against the Belfast Giants. Was that something you were aware of?
No, I didn't actually. That's crazy.
There you go. You learned something new.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
So what would you regard as the key qualities for a defence? When you mentioned the likes of Zdeno Chara, who's an epic player back in the day, what kind of qualities do you regard as the key things for a D-man?
I think for a defenseman, the biggest thing is just consistency. You got to give your coach an exact framework of what you're going to get when you're on the ice. And the game has changed a lot, whereas there used to be few and far between to have a super offensive defenseman that's constantly jumping up in the rush and bringing the puck and putting up a ton of points. And, now it's much more balanced. You usually have an even split between guys that are more offensive and guys that are more defensive or two-way players. For me, I still fit into that role of – you know, being able to produce on the offense, but knowing that when I'm out there, we're safe defensively. I'm going to play smart and help the guys in the defensive zone and chip in offensively when I can. You know, I'm not exactly fleet of foot, so I like to throw the body around a little bit and be heavy in front, and then just, you know, use my shot from the blue line to help with the offense.
Now, you first came to Europe in December 19. You joined the teams at Narvik in Norway, and then COVID hit a couple of months later. What was that like for you, given it was your first time in Europe at the time?
I was very lucky. It was an amazing experience being in Narvik. They're way up at the top of Norway. We're actually above the Arctic Circle up there, and it was a big change. They have, you know, my first few weeks was about 18 hours of darkness. The sun would just come up over the horizon for a couple hours in the middle of the day, and that was it. But, you know, I got to see the Northern Lights, and you know, we flew to every game because we were so far away. But that was a really cool experience playing in a great league against some really big teams. And, you know, I loved it. Yeah, I always knew that eventually I'd want to do a stint in Europe, and I was very lucky to start out in Norway and then, you know, continue it all the way to this point. It's been a great experience.
So we mentioned the fact you played in the playoff finals weekend with Guildford last year. You helped them get there, of course, being part of the team. And as an American, no doubt you're used to seeing the playoffs being played out in a best of seven format. So what did you make of the rather shorter format we have over here?
Yeah, that was a big change. It's the first league I played in where, you know, there's three different trophies. And really the biggest one, arguably, is winning the regular season. And then, you know, having the playoffs be a two-game aggregate score. It's the first time I had done that. I did it once in Sweden the year before, but it was definitely different. And it's funny, you know, being on a team with Dixon now where I'm still pretty devastated about going down to Cardiff that weekend. I think we, you know, we handled a ton of that game. And, you know, it still kills a little bit of my sleep thinking back at it. You know, it would have been nice to get to that final game, but it was really different, but it makes it so much more intense. The fact that, you know, the final weekend of the four teams is a one game elimination. There's so much on the line and guys are playing so hard. You know, it's very intense playoff hockey, and we were very fortunate to get to that point. It was tough going down that way, but it was a great experience.
And of course you've got all the fans on top of you as well, not just the fans of your own team, but everyone's fans were all in at the building that weekend as well. Really big atmosphere. And as a player, first time experiencing that, what did you make of that?
Yeah, it was insanely cool how they set it up and how, you know, all the fans come out whether or not their team's playing. You know, we did a walkthrough the day that we got there in downtown Nottingham, and it was absolutely packed. And you saw jerseys from every team, and it was just really lively. And, you know, having the rink structure where fans are in each section, and it's packed and loud, and you know, everybody's pulling for a team. And it was really cool having everyone right in the area. Obviously, in a league like this, you know, most guys have connections to someone on almost every team, and having a bunch of guys in the area, and, you know, it's a little tense before the game. You know, no one's a buddy until the buzzer goes off and everything's settled. But that was great. You know, we had an awesome team in Guildford and competed really well. But, you know, getting to have that experience was awesome. It was really fun being in that kind of environment and having fans from the whole league there. That's something I had never seen before.
And at Guildford, you played alongside John Dunbar and Jordan County, who you're reunited with here at the Clan. John said some nice things about you, about getting the chance to play with you again. I'm going to turn the tables on. What did you make of playing with John in Guildford last year?
Yeah, Dunny's awesome. He's a great guy off the ice, you know, someone you love to spend time with, and just a good team player. And obviously his skills on the ice are incredible. He has ridiculous hands. And, you know, my favorite comment with him is when he has the puck, you're always open. He always has to be ready. I learned that pretty quick playing on a power play unit with him last year. He's one of the best passers in the league. And, you know, it was great to come back to a team knowing both of those guys and getting to play with Dunny and Cowens again. They're both great players. And, you know, I really enjoy having those guys around. You know, like I said, the team here has been incredibly welcoming. You know, when you step into a locker room, sometimes it takes a few days to settle in. And then sometimes it's an experience like this where, you know, I feel at home and I feel right a part of the team immediately. And it's just a bonus to have those guys around.
Now, we had a brief chat before and you were telling me you've got a job at the moment. You're still doing that as well as playing for the Clan. Tell us a bit about that and how you factor that into your day.
Pretty much anyone that's close to me, but my friends and family are definitely not surprised that I'm back playing. You know, I've just had a crazy connection to hockey, and it was really tough to let it go. You know, I did well now unofficially retire at the end of last season. You know, I had played a long time. I'd gotten to an age, where I thought I was ready for it, and, you know, I'm incredibly lucky to be back now, but Yeah, I took a job as vice president of a company called Hearth and Patio Direct. We sell hearth products, so fireplaces, grills, fire pits, everything like that. And it's e-commerce, so it's all over the country. And I'm actually still doing it now. The nice part of the time change is, I'm back from practice and settled in and have lunch, and then it's, start work time back home. So it's great. I get keep myself busy, come back, get settled in and do my work. And being able to do both things is awesome. Obviously, I probably wouldn't have been able to do this if I couldn't work the job at the same time, or I would have had to leave the job for good. So, I'm balancing both of them right now, and it keeps me busy. But I'm very happy that I was able to come out and get some more games in.
And the fact you can keep your job going as well is obviously a bonus. It works really
Oh yeah.
nicely, as you said, with the time difference. Practice in the morning, by the time you get into the afternoon, it's morning, from where you're from as well. So it works out really well.
Yeah, no, it's great. Actually, I hung up on a work call right after, or right before I picked up with you here. Yeah, the time change is perfect. 5 hours is great. It gives me enough time to not be rushed back from the rink and, be able to get a workout in and still be able to eat and then settle in. I work into the night and, it's an awesome balance. My company was great at letting me do this. And, I've been balancing it so far. It's gonna be a long stretch here for sure. But, being able to have an opportunity like this where I can keep the job and still play hockey again, I was very excited to get back here.
Well, before I do let you get back to work, one more question for you, Jake. Another couple of games coming up this weekend, starting on Friday when the Fife Flyers come to town. You'll be aware it's a big rivalry game between the two teams. So how much of a lift can the team get by winning this one, considering the current form right now?
Yeah, I think everybody in our room knows that this is not only a winnable game, they're all winnable, but this is one that we really need, especially for the fans. Everyone's aware of what we've gone through this season and the battles that we've had to have, and the fans have been awesome showing up. I've only been on the ice for one of the games, but I watched the last home game before that, and it's been incredible. And that would be a big lift for us. The guys are certainly not out there with a lack of effort. We're not shooting ourselves in the foot. It's just, a bounce here or there, having guys out of the lineup that are big contributors. But I think we're ready. This is a game that we're gonna certainly go after, and there's a good chance to have it, and it's gonna be exciting. And I think we're gonna come out with 2 points.
And of course, the reaction's needed as well on the back of the result on Sunday against Coventry Blaze. Not the night for you guys, certainly, but a chance to put things right, certainly.
Yeah, no, absolutely. I mean, the offense is one of those things that's going to click. We have to help on the defensive end as much as we can. That was definitely a tough loss. We were right there. We had a ton of chances and just weren't getting the bounces. But this is a big game for us. It's going to be a great atmosphere. Fife's always a team that plays physical and is going to keep the building in the game. But it's a process, and getting this win is certainly, like I said, we're on the upturn. It's not something you just say. Things have been good. We're making big progressions. The guys that have taken over the coaching staff and running the video and the practices have done an amazing job. This could be a big one for us. And I think, either way it goes, we're still making steps every day. But yeah, I think this is a game that we're all prepared to go get 2 points.
Thank you.